Hey guys, hey class, today we're at the beach and we're going to be learning about sunstroke. So, our objective for today is to understand how, why, and when sunstroke occurs and how we can prevent it on hot days. To start, the definition of sunstroke is when your body is so hot it can no longer keep itself cool. Okay, your body is no longer able to regulate its temperature. Some of the causes include include dehydration, not enough sunscreen, or excessive sun exposure. We can prevent sunstroke a few different ways. Staying hydrated, staying out of the sun, and going swimming. Now we're going to do a little bit of problem solving using a few scenarios that we have here on the whiteboard. So, Andy and Char, I'm going to have you guys tell me what you would do in the following scenarios. The first scenario is you're on a very hot day, lots of sun, no breeze, haven't gone on the boat yet. Whatever you should bring, what should you bring or wear? So we're going to start with Andy.
What should I bring while I'm going out?
What should you bring and wear when you're about to go out on the boat in this scenario on a really hot day?
Okay, well. I would wear, like, not a lot of stuff, so probably just my life jacket and, maybe a hat to keep the sun out of my eyes. And then make sure that I'm hydrated, so I drink a lot of water beforehand, and then while I'm going out, if it gets, like, too hot while I'm out there, I would, take a dip in the lake and cool myself down.
Would you bring a water bottle?
I would. Or I would ask the instructor to bring it for me so I don't drop it in the water.
Yeah, if you're still in the 420, it might be hard, or 29, it might be hard to keep a water bottle in the boat. Shar,
right.
What about you?
Well, I think Andy pretty much said what I was going to say. But yeah, just remember, also you should bring
sunglasses.
If that was already mentioned. Because even though like that might not keep you cool, it'll stop.
It'll shield your eyes from the sun.
Yeah. So that's important. But yeah, other than that, he hit it off. But also, I would like drink a lot of water before I went on the boat so that I'd be hydrated from the beginning.
Yeah, hydrated. All right, second scenario. You're now out on the boat on a really hot day, feeling thirsty, but you don't have any water. How would you proceed?
Well, I would get the attention of the coach boat and ask them if they had any water that I could have, because if they were a prepared instructor, they should have at least brought out their own water that I could have a sip of, and hopefully, in this case, brought some extra water in case people ran out, or like in my case, forgot to bring it out.
Right. Andy, what about you?
If I didn't have any water, maybe I would get in the lake to cool down.
Cool down, because
I don't want to overheat. And then, I can't really keep in the shade while I'm up there, so I think that's why it's super important to have your hat and your sunglasses and everything. And apply a ton of sunscreen so that I don't burn myself.
Say the instructor didn't have any water, and the lake water obviously isn't drinkable. Would you head in at that point to avoid sunstroke?
I guess if I'm starting to feel dizzy and everything.
And that's the call, yeah. And for our last teaching method of the video, we're gonna do a bit of role playing where Andy, you're gonna act out a sailor who is very prepared on a really hot beach day, and Shara is going to act up someone who's very unprepared. You guys have 1 minute to gather some materials from the material pile and go.
Okay.
So I'm the prepared guy?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You guys almost ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Here, scooch back a bit. All right, so Shar, you seem very unprepared.
Well, what are you saying? I'm ready for my beach day, so I have like a lay on and a bathing suit. I have some glasses and I have a ukulele, so we can chill out and play some music at the beach. And I have a hat.
Andy, what about you? You seem a lot more prepared.
Well, what I have is I got my sunscreen on so that I don't burn myself. This is my bottle of water, so I'm gonna stay hydrated while I'm out there. I got my hat protecting my face so that I don't burn all of this. And I got my sunglasses with actual lenses in them to protect my eyes. And I'm also wearing a life jacket.
You seem much more prepared. Shar, you just
What's
don't...
wrong with my outfit?
You don't have a life jacket on. Your hat is not covering your face, which means your face is exposed to the sun. You don't have sunscreen, and you don't have a water bottle.
I have glasses, though.
But they don't have lenses in them.
Oh, okay. So I know how to dress for next time. How could I be better?
Be more like Andy.
What? If she didn't bring her stuff, how does she know that she's starting to feel heat stroke?
Some symptoms include dizziness, hallucinations, and general dehydration. And you can feel that, and if you start to feel that, contact your instructor immediately and get off the water, go for a swim, start to hydrate, and be more like Andy. Thanks, guys. Good lesson.
Thanks,
Will. You're the best.